Following last week's chaos that rocked the various by-elections in the country and which were marred by incidences of bribery and intimidation, the Interior Ministry swung into action by issuing withdrawal of guns to members accused of partaking in the violent acts.
We want these elections to be stopped and we are not going to be derailed by cases.
NCIC would follow suit by summoning the political class over the chaotic scenes witnessed. Today, a number of those mentioned in the disturbing scenes would make appearances across the various institutions across the country. At a Kiambu court earlier in the day, former Cabinet Secretary Rashid Chesa will be forced to spend another night in custody pending determination of a bail hearing where he is accused of slapping an IBC official during an altercation.
They are asking him for 4 days to investigate this matter. What have they done in the meantime? Wasted 4 days by coming to Nairobi. 4 days.
The prosecution is seeking to detain Chesa for 7 more days and a ruling on the same will be made on Tuesday.
You only need the person who was assaulted, the P3, and the police officer will investigate. So which rocket science is he telling us that he wants to go to the moon, to the stars, and carry out activities in Mumias? He said he's going to Mumias.
I remand the suspect at Gigiri police station until tomorrow at 11 a.m. for that ruling.
In Kakamega, Senator Cleopas Malala presented himself before the police following a directive by the DCI and was later, after interrogation, released on a police bond.
On Wednesday, tumeambiwa turudi kotini. Tuende kotini, mimi nikiwemo moja wao, tuende tuangalie kama watatushtaki. Sijui watatushtaki kwa nini, kwa sababu sijui kama watatushtaki kwa kushinda kura, ama watatushtaki kwa kukua pamoja kama Waluya.
In Kisii County, South Mugirango Member of Parliament Silvanus Osoro was also charged in court after presenting himself before the police and charged with incitement to violence that resulted to damaging of property totaling to 200,000 shillings.
When people talk about the dark days of the 1990s, in the 1990s it was legal to have arbitrary arrests, but we changed the law.
I hear from the rumors that it has everything to do with the Kiambu Kamabai election.
There are easier ways of looking for a member of parliament. One, through his office in the constituency. There is no message, official message. There is also through parliament, the clerk of the National Assembly and the speaker, if you are looking for a member of parliament.
The MP was later released on a 100,000 shillings bond or a cash bail of 50,000 shillings.
Leo umenishika, kesho najua mtashika mwingine. Lakini tena kujeni hapa tena munisike. Nirudi, nitalipa cash bail. Sina shida.
Meanwhile, nominated Senator Millicent Omanga would cause a stir at the NCIC offices after alleging that she was kept waiting for long.
Yeah. You tell me one, I'll have come here at one. You told me at 11. So if you knew you are taking an hour or two for each and every member, you should have calculated, give me my day.
And we expected that
we came here before 11, Mushimi.
Gladys Wanga, who was expected to present herself at the NCIC Commission, failed to honor the summons over what she said was celebrating International Women's Day. Wanga maintained that NCIC seems to be returning to the dark days in a statement posted on her social media pages, saying that invitations appear choreographed to cover up for those who committed electoral offenses, including physical assault of IBC officials, including women, for which I bitterly protested. This comes even as Didmus Barasa sued the state over confiscation of his firearm. Martin Opio, K24 TV.